Now listen here. If the ordered pairs x squared minus 3x comma y squared plus 4y and minus 2 comma 5 are equal, so both the pairs are equal, then find x and y. So usually ordered pairs, how will you represent x comma y? So the first one is x coordinate, the second one is y coordinate. Suppose if it is AB, if both the ordered pairs are equal, x is equated with A, x is equal to A, then y is equated with B. In the same way, here x squared minus 3x equal to minus 2. X squared minus 3x is equated with minus 2 because x coordinate is equated with x coordinate. Similarly, next one, y squared plus 4y equal to 5. Y coordinate is equated with y coordinate. Do you follow? Now, x squared minus 3x, this minus 2, when it goes to LHS, it will become plus 2. Then equated with 0. Similarly here, y squared plus 4y, then plus 5, when it comes to LHS, minus 5. Equal to 0. Don't forget to write the 0. This is a quadratic equation. Then it is very easy to find out the x value. How will you find out the x value? By factorizing. You have to do the factorization. So first you see the constant term. What is constant term? Plus 2. What is coefficient of x? Minus 3. I told you previously, actually 2-3 videos already I posted, and also with the help of algebraic tiles how you can factorize, I told you. So just you listen to me. Constant term is plus, then both the numbers have the same symbol. Either it is plus or both are minus. Both the numbers, they will have the same symbol. Either it may be plus or minus. So you have to decide whether it is plus or minus. How will you decide? With the help of the coefficient of x. If the coefficient of x is minus, then both the numbers are minus symbol. Here it is minus, so both the numbers are minus symbol. When you multiply the two numbers, you have to get the constant term. When you add the same two numbers, you have to get the coefficient of x. Please children, listen to me carefully. So, 2 into 1, here nearby you can write. 2 into 1 is 2. But what symbol is here? Minus. So, minus 2 into minus 1. What? Plus 2. Minus into minus plus 2, 1 is 2. Here, minus 2 and minus 1. When you add, what will you get? Minus 3. So, what are the factors here? X minus 2, X minus 1. Is it okay? That's all. So, x minus 2 is equated with 0. X minus 1 is equated with 0. So, x is equal to 0. Minus 2 when it comes to RH is plus 2. Actually, this step is not necessary. Directly, you can write the answer. X equal to 2. X equal to 2. Here, x equal to 0, minus 2 when it goes to RHS, plus 1. So, x equal to 1. Do you follow? The same way for y. What is constant term here? Minus 5. What is coefficient of y? It is not x. What is coefficient of y? Plus 4. When constant term is plus, you will have the same symbol. When constant term is minus, you will have the different symbol. You will have the different symbol. One is plus and another one is minus. So, one is plus and another one is minus. So, when you multiply these two numbers, you have to get minus 5. When you add these two numbers, you have to get plus 4. That means subtract. Why I am saying subtract? Because symbols are different. So, 5-1 is 5. 5-1 is 5. Actually, here 5 minus 1 is 4. So, for 5, what is the symbol? Plus. For 1, what is the symbol? Minus. So, plus into minus minus 5-1 is 5. 5 minus 1 plus 4. So, what are the factors? Y plus 5 into y minus 1 equal to 0. These are all for explanation I am writing. Those who are able to do it directly you write it and try to finish within the time. Y plus 5 equal to 0. Y minus 1 equal to 0. Y equal to 0 plus 5 when it goes to other side, minus 5. So, y equal to minus 5. Y equal to 0 plus 1. That is y equal to 1. Is it okay? So, you remember this condition. When the constant term is plus, both the numbers have the same symbol, either plus or minus. When the constant term is minus, both the numbers will have the different symbol. Plus, one is plus and another one is minus. Which number is plus, which number is minus? That you have to decide with the help of the coefficient of y. Do you follow? For the bigger number, you will have the symbol. For 5, what is the symbol? Plus. Do you follow? So, some of the students, you may like to write like this. Do the factorization in this way. How is it? X squared. This coefficient of x is nothing but minus 2 into minus 1. That is minus 2x. Minus 1x plus 2 equal to 0. Actually, it is not necessary. You can do it in this way. Some of the teachers, they will ask you to write like this. So, just you can. What is common in these two terms? X is common. Then what is remaining here? X. How will you find out that remaining? When you multiply these two, you have to get this term. X into x, x square. Then plus into minus, minus. X you have taken out. So, what is remaining here? Minus 2. So, if you get x minus 2, then automatically here also what will you get? X minus 2 only. So, according to that you take the number. What is it? Minus 1. Minus 1 into x minus x. Minus 1 into minus 2 plus 2. Then what is common? X minus 2, x minus 2. Here in this term x minus 2, in this term also x minus 2. So, what is here? X minus 2. Then what is remaining? What is left out? X. Here what is left out? Minus 1. So equal to 0. Don't forget this. So same way. X minus 2 equal to 0. Then x equal to 2. X minus 1 equal to 0. Then x equal to 1. Do you follow? Same way. Y square plus 4y minus 5 equal to 0. You have to split this y term. What is it? Plus 5y minus y minus 5 equal to 0. So, what is common? Y is common for these two terms. Then, here what you have to write? Y. Y into y, y square. Here what? Y plus 5. If you get y plus 5, then automatically here also what will you get? Y plus 5. According to that, you take the common one. What is it? Minus 1. Minus 1 into y minus y. Minus 1 into plus 5 minus y equal to 0. Then, here what is common? Y plus 5. Sorry, here. Y plus 5. Here what is left out? Why you are taking y plus 5? Y. Here y plus 5 you have taken out. What is remaining? Y minus. So same way. Y plus 5 equal to 0. Y minus 1 equal to 0. Y equal to minus 5. Y equal to 1. You can do this or this. Do you follow? Here also, to solve this also, y plus 5 equal to 0, no? How you can do? Y plus 5 by adding minus 5 on both the sides. So, this will be get cancelled. So, y equal to minus 5. Y minus 1, adding plus 1 on both the sides. So, get cancelled. Y equal to 1. Do you follow for this part? Alternate. Here, same way. X minus 2 means adding plus 2 on both the sides. So, x equal to 2. X minus 1 means adding plus 1 on both the sides. Do you follow? So, x equal to 1. Because 0 is here. If you are adding plus 1 in LHS, you have to add plus 1 in RHS. Whatever you are doing for LHS, you have to do it for RHS also. Do you follow, my dear? Every one of you? So, find out the value for x and y. Is it there or not? That's all. Thank you.